Hey WordPress users, do you want to know everything you need to know about the latest big update in WordPress 5.4? Then you've come to the right place. Hey guys, what's up? This is Ruben at TenWeb, a managed WordPress hosting platform powered by Google Cloud. In this video, I'm going to walk you through all the important improvements in this WordPress update. First, we'll talk about the general section improvements, then about block editor improvements, and finally about the new features for WordPress developers. Also, I'm going to be mentioning some of the features that were supposed to be included in this update, but were delayed for the next release, WordPress 5.5. And if you're interested in a specific part of this video, I have left some time codes for you to click around. And if you're looking for more WordPress-related content, such as reviews and info about updates, make sure to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to always get notified. Also, if you have any questions about this specific WordPress update or WordPress in general, make sure to leave them in the comment section down below. Now let's go over the general section improvements you should be expecting. There are a lot of features, improvements, and bug fixes, especially coming to the block editor. But we'll talk about Gutenberg a little bit later. In terms of general updates, there are two main things. Firstly, the Gutenberg plugin, or rather a bunch of its versions up until 7.5, is now merged into core. So if you have been using it before, you will notice a big change. And the second one is a tool that's been added to the dashboard, and that's website health tool added to the WordPress 5.2 for measuring site health, which is a combination of security and performance. Those are the general things, but the main improvements have been made to the block editor, of course. And despite all the hate that WordPress got for moving towards a block editor, it has actually made things more efficient. For one, now it takes less time to load and type a long blog post. But let me show it to you in more detail.
Okay guys, let's quickly take a look at what's new here in this editor. And the first thing that should come to your sight is that it automatically opens in the full screen mode, which is okay, but I realize a lot of you might be accustomed to the good old dashboard that usually appears on the left side. So if you want to have it back, you can simply go to the upper right corner here and disable the full screen mode by just clicking on it. Here we go. Now, if you want to know what's new generally in this edition, you can go to the welcome guide, which can be found in this menu also. You can go down a little bit and find the welcome guide here. Now, this is going to give you some intro information about what this block editor is. But if you want to have some more detailed info, you can go to the last slide and follow the link that says here's a detailed guide. Now, the first cool thing I want to talk about is the new buttons block that gives you more cool functionalities you can play around with. Now, to do that, I'm going to add a button, which you can do by either clicking on this add block plus sign and find the buttons here, or you can simply enter slash and from the drop down menu, find the buttons option. Let's write something like now, and let's see what we can do with it. Here on the right side, you can see you can change the text color. Let's go with pink. And for the background, let's choose this quirky combination. But the cool thing is that you can go to the styles and turn your button to gradient color variation. Here you can choose from existing templates or create a gradient of your own. I'll go with this one. Here you can play around with the colors, which is very cool. Okay. Now, another thing I want to talk about is the new social icons block, which can be activated just like the buttons, either from here or by typing slash and choosing it from here, social icons. Here you can see it gives you some prompts, options to choose from, but of course you don't have to choose all of them. The cool thing about this option is that you can just enter the exact URL to the social media you're choosing. Let's go with Facebook. Let's go Facebook.com. And here you can see if you click out of the box, it's going to save the icons, those icons that you provided URLs for. Now, the next thing is that it's much easier to play around with text color, which wasn't the case with the previous edition. Now, what you can do is change colors to exact words or lines you choose from the text. Previously, you could change the background color and the text color only for the whole text block. Now it's much better. Let's enter a dummy text here. Here we go. And let's say I want to change the color for this exact part of the text. I can just choose it and go to the arrow here, click on it, go to the text color option and choose the color I want. Let's go with green. Here we go. This is very awesome. And finally, I've got some good news for TikTok lovers, because now there is an option to embed videos from TikTok, just like it used to be with YouTube. What you can do for that is, just like with the other options, you can go to this menu, the plus sign. Here I already have it here, but if you don't, for some reason, if it doesn't show you here, you can go down, go to embeds section and find TikTok here. Here, what you need to do is to provide the exact URL to the video you want to embed. And that's it, guys. These are the six main changes that were inserted to this edition of this editor. And I'm sure a lot of people are going to appreciate that.
Okay, now let's move on to some of the features and improvements that were made specifically for WordPress developers. And the main ones include the ability to use a shortcode in PHP files, the ability to handle favicon requests better, which is especially useful for theme developers, the addition of two new action hooks for adding custom fields to menu items. The next one is the ability to get more info about login errors, also very important. And a few changes that were made to REST API, such as the addition of selective link embeddings. And while this was a major update, a bunch of changes were delayed and will only come with WordPress 5.5. And the main two of these delayed updates are the addition of a navigation block and the addition of image lazy load. Well, we'll be keeping an eye out for these delayed updates and we'll keep you posted for sure. To sum it up, there are quite a few changes coming for WordPress users, especially regarding the Gutenberg editor blocks. And it's safe to say that a couple of plugins were made redundant by this major release. You know what else would be a huge game changer for your WordPress website? TenWeb's free 14-day trial of the best WordPress-specific managed hosting on cloud that comes with every feature that your WordPress website might ever need. And you don't have to provide any credit card information, so just follow the link in the description and test out all of the awesome features that TenWeb offers. I hope you enjoyed this overview of the upcoming changes to WordPress and will not be surprised by the update. Don't forget to like, share, and most importantly, subscribe to our channel to always get notified whenever there's new content. We post almost every weekday. See you next time.